Good afternoon, students. Today we will do the essay of sodium chloride by von Hartz method. In previous experiment, we have done the essay of sodium chloride by Mohr's method, in which there was no acidic medium used. But in von Hartz method, this is the main requirement that it should be carried out in acidic medium. And here the nitric acid is providing you the acidic medium. So what is the procedure? We are taking ammonium thiocyanate in the burette. This is used for standardization of sodium chloride, silver nitrate. Then in the conical flask we are taking sodium chloride, water, silver nitrate, nitric acid, which is giving you the acidic medium, plus the most important component of this titration is nitrobenzene. Then the indicator, which is ferric ammonium sulfate, all of them will react together to give you the reddish yellow precipitates. Precipitates will be definitely formed in this titration, since these are the precipitation titrations, right? So in the end, the precipitates will always be formed. So two main questions are asked in this titration: why we are adding nitric acid and what is the role of nitrobenzene. First is role of nitric acid. It is giving you the acidic medium to carry out this titration. Now, nitrobenzene. First you understand the equations, then I will tell you the role of nitrobenzene. What happens in this titration is, sodium chloride, which we have taken in the conical flask, is reacting with excess of silver nitrate. See, we are taking 50 ml of silver nitrate. So actually it is a kind of back titration, in which initially sodium chloride is reacting with silver nitrate, then excess or unreacted silver nitrate. Excess means, so first sodium chloride is reacting with silver nitrate to give you silver chloride, right? So silver nitrate here is not completely consumed. So the unreacted or excess of silver nitrate here is back titrated with ammonium thiocyanate, which is taken in the burette, to give you silver thiocyanate plus ammonium nitrate. But what happens here is, silver thiocyanate also wants to react with ammonium thiocyanate, and silver chloride formed here also wants to react with ammonium thiocyanate. Both of them are competing together that I will react with ammonium thiocyanate. And moreover, silver chloride is more soluble than silver thiocyanate. So they are fighting with each other to react with ammonium thiocyanate. So what we want to do is, we want the silver thiocyanate should react with the indicator and should give you the final product. But how we will catch hold of silver chloride? We will either do the filtration and we will remove the silver chloride, or what nitrobenzene will do, it will coagulate the silver chloride. Coagulation means, suppose this is your silver chloride, it will form a layer outside the silver chloride. Nitrobenzene is forming a layer outside the silver chloride so that it does not react with ammonium thiocyanate. We don't want the silver chloride to react with ammonium thiocyanate, right? Simple words में अगर आप समझना चाहो तो ये देखो
कि सिल्वर क्लोराइड एक चोर है और नाइट्रोबेंजीन एक पुलिस है। पुलिस ने चोर के आसपास एक जाल बिछा दिया है ताकि वो कोई चोरी ना कर सके। यही रोल है सिल्वर नाइट्रोबेंजीन का कि सिल्वर क्लोराइड वाले चोर को पकड़ के रखना है कि तूने रिएक्ट नहीं करना अमोनियम थायसाइनेट के साथ। तो किसका रिएक्शन होना चाहिए? सिल्वर थायसाइनेट विल रिएक्ट विद सिल्वर नाइट्रेट विल रिएक्ट विद दिस अमोनियम थायसाइनेट टू गिव यू सिल्वर थायसाइनेट एंड फाइनली अमोनियम थायसाइनेट विच इज टेकन इन द ब्यूरिन विल रिएक्ट विद दिस इंडिकेटर विच इज फेरिक अमोनियम सल्फेट और FAS टू गिव यू द फाइनल प्रेसिपिटेट्स रेडिश कलर्ड प्रेसिपिटेट्स ऑफ फेरिक थायोसाइनेट। सो दिस इज फेरिक थायोसाइनेट रेडिश प्रेसिपिटेट्स। So I am once again repeating the role of nitrobenzene. Initially what happens is sodium chloride is reacting with silver nitrate to give you the silver chloride precipitates. Now this is a back titration. We have a huge amount of silver nitrate, that is 50 ml. So the unreacted silver nitrate, this is unreacted or excess of silver nitrate is reacting with ammonium thiocyanate to give you the silver thiocyanate, right? Now these two, silver thiocyanate and silver chloride, they both are fighting each other to react with ammonium thiocyanate. But we don't want that. We want that only silver thiocyanate should be formed and ammonium thiocyanate should react with the indicator to give you the final product, which is ferric thiocyanate. So this is the chemical basis of this titration, and with this formula of percentage purity, we can calculate the purity.